It's a fact that today Europe does not have this capacity. It is also a fact that if corresponding decisions are taken at the end of the year, Europe will have it tomorrow. And in fact, at ESA, we had already a technology demonstration of a reentry on Earth, which took place a few years ago in an experimental vehicle called IXV. And based on this experience, which was highly successful and launched by Vega, by the way, we are now developing Space Rider. During low Earth orbit operation in microgravity, the vehicle can turn, maneuver according to the mission it has. And then, at the moment in time you start the re-entry on Earth, in fact, you have a dedicated angle of attack. You start to enter into the atmosphere. And this is what we call a lifting body, meaning there are no plane type of structures. It's just the body which has a certain angle of attack, enters into the upper part of the atmosphere at high speed. We call it hypersonic. And then the speed is decreased through the drag. And when it starts to become subsonic, you have lowered significantly the speed. And once you have reached a certain level, you can deploy a parafoil. And once with the parafoil deployed, you can have a precision landing on the runway somewhere in Europe. We do a call for opportunities, and we will have different flight opportunities planned. For example, in microgravity research. So if you are coming from a university, that's for sure an opportunity. Like in material sciences or pharmaceutical field, biological field at large scale. Second, we will work on commercial opportunities, and here we have already quite good exchanges, again with the pharmaceutical industry. And we will look for further in-orbit validation and demonstration of technologies which have to be tested and qualified in space before they go on big and costly missions.